Hi, I'm Talia. This is my daughter, Aliana. I'm 19, and she's 10 months. And today is our first vlog. Yay! Say yay!
Our first vlog! Yay, Ali! Yay!
Okay, so this is our first vlog, and this is like our third time shooting it, honestly. I'm gonna be honest. But today I'm going to be talking about finding out I was pregnant at a young age. I was 17 when I found out, moving out of my parents' house and graduating and everything. So I found out I was pregnant last year. I think it was like end of April, April 27th, something like that. So graduation was like a month away, and so I was so nervous when I found out because I was a few credits short. I wasn't the best student at the moment, so I didn't have my shit together like at all. So I was like, oh my god, what am I gonna do? Luckily, I ended up graduating, but I didn't tell my parents that I was pregnant until my first appointment, which was May 24th. And, then I found out that my younger sister was pregnant. Like, she was like, oh my goodness, I haven't got my kid, I'm so scared. So then she went and took a test. She was pregnant too, but she didn't tell my parents until she found out the sex and everything. Like, she kept the secret for like super long. I'm surprised they never found out. Like, they were kind of suspicious of me because in the beginning I was throwing up so much. So my dad was like, what's wrong with her? You know, like, what? But, you know, since I was like older and I was graduating and everything, I was more eager to tell them. I wasn't as worried. So I told them earlier than her. And so, fast forward through the summer, and we found out the sex, it's a girl, I already had the name picked out, we already agreed and everything, didn't have a middle name yet, so, I'm gonna skip through. Oh no, wait, almost forgot. We moved in together at the end of the summer, so we officially moved in, and it was crazy because I was pregnant, and like that was like the official move in. Like, I was not going to my parents' house at all, really. And it was crazy because we did it when I was pregnant, and that must have been like the hardest thing to do because my hormones were going crazy. I was super sensitive, like crazy emotional, like oh my god. But everything ended up working out. So fast forward to December, labor and delivery. I was in like pre-dominal labor for at least 4 weeks before her due date. Her due date was December 27th of 2016, and like Christmas rolled around, I'm like, oh my god, where is she? I keep having these predominant labor pains, like these aren't Braxton Hicks anymore, they're more and more uncomfortable. And so Christmas rolled around, I was like, okay, I'm getting her out. I went all on Google, and so I bounced on a yoga ball all day long, and nothing happened. And so on the 26th, I woke up. On the 26th, I woke up and I was having sharp pain. So I was like, okay, well, let me see if I have to go to the bathroom. And that wasn't the case. Oh, come here. I gotta pause the video. I'll pick up where I left off December 26th. Okay, so December 26th, I woke up with a sharp pain, and that was the beginning of my labor. I didn't get admitted into the hospital until the 27th, and on the 27th, I had to go to the hospital twice. Once at 6 a.m. and once at 10 p.m. because they sent me home the first time because I wasn't dilated far enough. The second time, I was 4 centimeters. And they were able to... and they were able to admit me. And so I would have to say that
for myself, I have to cut it short because she's gonna be waking up soon. Long story short, it took 2 days for me to get admitted to the hospital. Once they finally did that, it was kind of difficult for me to get the epidural and everything, but once I pushed her out, which was difficult for me too, it was the best day of my life. It was completely amazing. I don't know how to describe it besides those words. Like, the pain was totally, completely worth it. I had stitches in the inside, which is normal. What no one tells you about childbirth and labor and delivery is that the recovery is going to be one of the hardest parts, and you're going to have to really take it slow and give your body time to recover. So just remember that, and remember to focus on you and your baby and give yourself time to recover mentally and physically, that you're adjusting to a totally, completely new life. So give yourself time. And I hope you guys enjoyed my video. Comment below if you have any questions, comments. If you guys have any topics you want me to discuss, you want to see me, my boyfriend, and the baby as a family, you want to see me and my sister and our babies on the video, you have any, you know, like I said, discussion topics, questions, anything. Thank you for watching. Have a good day. Bye.